everybody. Welcome back to Captain Jack's Pirate Hats. Today we're going to talk about stretching the felt. Now, milliners use many different types of techniques and devices to prepare their material to be blocked. Some use the old tea kettle method to produce their steam. Others use various professional clothing steamers. I don't actually use any of those. I use a totally different process that I've developed over the past years, and it works best for me. So for that reason, I'll be keeping that a secret. But if you remember, this is our 23-inch block. We're going to use that today, and we're going to use a piece of rust-colored felt that you can see, again, is not a machine-blocked piece of felt. It's a plain piece of felt, and I'll be right back. Now that I've done that process, you can see that the felt is very, very pliable and ready to be stretched over the block. So we're going to take this piece of felt, center it, and we're just going to stretch it while we rotate the block. Then using our block cord, we are going to tighten down the crown. So after we've tightened down the edge of the crown and tacked it down so that it stays tight, we then stretch the felt out to the edges of the brim block. And we similarly will tack all of that down. Now that our felt has been completely blocked, it's time for our first application of stiffener. Captain Jack's uses a proprietary amber stiffener that we make on site. I will say that I use 3 times more stiffener when shaping a hat than other professional milliners. My hats are stiff and will retain their shape long after our competitors have gone limp. Now, buying a hat blank like this off the web and making your own tricorn, that's one thing. If you're going to go to the expense of buying a professionally made hat, there's no reason to settle for less. At Captain Jack's Pirate Hats, you're getting exactly what you pay for. A pirate hat made using the highest quality materials, designed to your specifications, and handcrafted by a master milliner. We spray our stiffener onto our hat block liberally using a spray bottle, an overlapping mist. This is the best way to accomplish an even application, allowing the felt to get really damp. Then when we're done with that, we brush the stiffener into the felt. Once we're done brushing the stiffener into the felt, we'll move it to our drying room for the hat to cure. This hat will be sprayed 2 or 3 more times during the shaping process. So we place the hat in the drying rack. Next time on Captain Jack's Pirate Hats, we'll cover shaping a hat. Please subscribe, like, and share. Thanks, mates.